Good morning, friends. Today morning, we are going to hear about unbelief. John chapter 12, verse 37. But although he had done so many signs before them, they did not believe in him. The primary sin for which the whole world is guilty of is sin of unbelief. This is the basis of all sin. Unbelief doesn't mean doubt, but choosing not to believe in God. Unbelief means refusing to accept God's authority over our lives. Another name of unbelief is lack of faith. Faith means active belief and trust in God's word. It is impossible to have faith unless we first hear God's word. But if after hearing, we then refuse to trust and obey, then that is called unbelief. Hebrews chapter 3, verse 12. Beware, brethren, lest there be in any of you an evil heart of unbelief in departing from the living God. Most of us view unbelief as something regrettable but completely harmless. But here God's word says, unbelieving heart is a wicked heart. Unbelief is evil because it causes us to fall away from living God. Faith in God establishes a relationship with God. Unbelief destroys our relationship with God. A person who has an unbelieving heart does not come under the authority of God. He becomes a rebellion towards God. He stays away from love of God, goodness of God. He cannot receive forgiveness of God, neither can he enjoy freedom of life in God. An unbelieving heart makes our life bondaged in prison of sin and thus disconnected from God. Unbelief is the source of all other sin. And the result of unbelief is still very serious for people today. Unbelief will ruin a person's relationship with God. And because God is a living God, nothing is more important than to have a right relationship with him. The true belief is based on the nature of God himself. If we have complete belief in God's nature, of his goodness, his wisdom and power, then we will never be disobedient towards God. If we believe God is good in every situation of our life, if we believe God wants only best thing for us, and he has the wisdom to know what is best and the power to provide it, then we would never have a motive for disobedience. An unbelieving heart is actually a disobedient heart. Unbelief doubts goodness of God. Unbelief doubts love of God. Unbelief denies wisdom and power of God. So I want to encourage you, friends, let us examine our heart if there is unbelief towards God and his word. If today we hear the voice of God, let us not harden our heart in unbelief. May God bless us with this word. Thank you.